itself depicts the power of women. Do you really know how a 12-year-old girl who laid the foundation of world's largest fully residential unit used to be? The girl, as you all know, the name Shrishanta Bai, who thought of women education and empowerment at the age of just 12 years. India has quite a good number of such examples where the women have shown their marvelous leadership skills. Shreya, can you enlighten us with your views?
Thank you, Anjali. Now, to extend upon your point, I would like to give the example of Ahilya Bai. She took over the Maratha throne after the demise of her loved ones. And she made Indore reach the heights of excellence during her 30-year rule. Now, if you look at the functions of corporate governance, it consists of the processes, mechanisms, and relations that are required for controlling and directing an organization or corporation. I would like to draw a parallel between the two. And when we see the functions of Ahilya Bai and that of the practitioner of corporate governance are very much similar to each other. So if women back then could do it, then why can't women in today's time do the same?
So, are you trying to draw a parallel?
Yeah.
I would like to ask you, Drishti, what's your opinion on it? Do you think this makes women better practitioners of corporate governance in respect of strategy making, vision, and planning?
# women the change maker. Leadership is not concerned about the gender. It needs competencies. Why we always appreciate a leader? Why don't we appreciate who produce it? Becoming a manager in today's world-class company is no longer that a few women can achieve. I will elaborate it a little more. I will frame an example of Jack Ma. Jack Ma is the founder of Alibaba. Alibaba has closely 49% of women workers, which is a lot for the high-tech company. It is the e-commerce company, which is a service industry, which need a serving heart to serve people better. I think women are doing much better jobs than a men. Men compete with muscle. Now, this is not the competition of muscles. Actually, this is the competition of wisdom. If any person want to be successful in his life, then he should have high EQ. If you don't want to lose quickly, then you should have high IQ. And if you want to be respected, then you should have high LQ, the Q of love. If you put these three Qs together, a lot of men have high IQ, low EQ, and a little bit of LQ. But women balance their voice. So, women are the best. If you talk about the operating of wisdom, the characteristic, the principle, as we see a lady, as a picture of a lady, as a general rule, she sacrificed the mother touch, the care, the ability of multitasking, collaboration of work style, strong sense of dedication, creating networks, and lot more. Women are leaders everywhere, as you know, from the CEO who runs the Fortune 500 companies, and the housewife who raise their children, and that's it for your question. I'm here.
Well said, Drishti. As we all know, women are more oriented towards growth and development, and also as per the reports of Fortune 500 companies, the top companies with highest sales have women in their boards already. Nikita, do you think there is a link between increased sales and increased women on board?
Thank you, Anjali. For adding to what just Drishti said, I would say women on board leads to more profit in an organization. I'll quote probably for credit, so she last year said, companies which have at least one woman on board leads to more profit and receives a better return on investment compared to the companies having less women or no women in the board. The companies which have women on board, more women on board, actually experiences what we call innovation intensity and produces more patent, while an average of 20% is comparatively with the companies having all male members in the boardroom. Further, talking about the same, Joy Carrera, the assistant dean at the University of Arizona at the College of Management, says, innovation is fundamentally the result of trial and error. And if you are able to bring together these two things, you do a better job and women do the same. Further, I would like to cite two examples here. The first takes of Sheryl Sandberg, CEO of Facebook. She joined Facebook in 2012, and after her joining, the profit of the company has been raised to $3.4 billion, and the market price of the company, actually market value of the company, raised to $350 billion by 2016. And the second example is of Indra Nooyi. After she left the company PepsiCo, the market price of the shares has been drastically fallen. And this is why I think women are more important to a company, as company is always set up for the purpose of profit maximization, and women help to achieve the motive. Thank you.
I completely agree with you, Nikita. Moving towards a move from gender discrimination to gender diversity, what kind of movement is this, and how do you think this will help a company decision making? Could you tell me the advantages of a diverse board?
Sure, Anjali. More the number of women on the board, better the administration. As we all know, that there is still the very low percentage of women who are participating in the corporate institutions. A study on gender diversity in corporate leadership has shown that women participation in the global economy is not to the same extent as men. Another example could be of Taekyung Kim. He is the professor at the, he is assistant professor at the University of Toronto, and said that diversity, the diverse team is very, very necessary in a corporate institution. He also said that women are the bone to corporate institutions. Functionally, diverse teams help in bringing innovative ideas and bringing better strategies to the corporate institutions. So in my opinion, it is very, very necessary to include women on the board, and still the required percentage of women on the board is very less, which has to be increased. Thank you.
Thank you, Riddhi. I would like to mention a report. A report showing the women leadership gap. The report reveals women fill 52% of professional jobs, yet they make up only 16% of Fortune 500 board. Why do women lag behind despite possessing so many qualities? What are your views, Riddhi?
Okay, Anjali. In my opinion, it is immoral to exclude women from the board, because the increased gender diversity is helpful in achieving more equitable outcome for the society. According to me, the main basis of discrimination of women in today's era is basically because of two reasons. First one is double responsibilities, and the second is glass ceiling. We see that women are the center of family life, and they have to face many responsibilities. They feel career breaks because of childbirth and subsequent care of children. These are the double responsibilities, and she has to combine her work with the household responsibilities. So it is a double burden on a woman. Another reason which I gave was glass ceiling. Glass ceiling is a metaphor coined in the Wall Street Journal report, where they stated that glass ceiling is an invisible barrier which prevents a woman in entering the business world, in reaching the top positions in the business world. So basically, these two are the reasons where women are discriminated. Another problem faced by women are sexual harassment at workplace. So about 1/4 of the women face sexual harassment at workplace. These all barriers create very much anxiety and depression among women, which affects the efficiency in their performance. So we need to tackle these problems, and encourage women to participate in the corporate institution as much as they can.
Thank you. Besides class ceiling and sexual harassment, there are certain other obstacles too which are faced by the women in corporate world. Also, our quota system is not moving in the right direction. Don't you think, Drishti, just for the sake of corporate governance, family members like women and daughters are being added to fill that one seat of independent director?
Yes, I do think so. Security and Exchange Board of India, SEBI, had asked to company to appoint at least one woman in the board. Because as per the rule of Company Act 2013, it aimed at improving the gender diversity. As per the report of April 2015, as Hindustan Times has given, many companies have appointed their family members, including their wives, their daughters, to just fill the position of directors or fill the positions of, or just the sake of regulatory deadline to be completed. So I don't think so. This is fair enough because this is can't done overnight. As if 3 to 4 years to train someone to be a director on the company board is a huge responsibility. What are busy looking women who have a spark, who can innovate or who can push the growth of the company? Successful women encourage other women at all levels and empower them to be a good person or to occupy that space in the board. And that's it for the question.
Nikita, do you want to add something? Though the number of women in corporate world is still less, but the quality they possess are so good that they help a company to reach higher levels. Further, talking about the qualities, I would like to tell you the most important qualities of women on board, having women on board. Women create a well-rounded workforce when it comes to sensitivity, intuitions, and emotional intelligence. They outrun men. And because of these qualities, they create a well-rounded workforce. Taking an example of Indra Singh, she writes letter to the parents of her employees in order to thank them for the children. As according to her, employees are the key important part of the, in an organization, which helps an organization to work effectively and efficiently. And because of these qualities of sensitivity, intuitions and emotional intelligence, they are able to address and resolve many problems, many workforce problems before they even crop up. And further talking about the other quality, their risk servers. The company which has hit its critical mass of women in board approaches risk more realistically and think more broadly. And because of this, they avoid risk, we can say, so they don't eliminate, but they avoid risk. And in the survey of Fidelity survey, it has been said that female investors have outperformed male investors by 2.3% in 2016 while taking less risk. And these two qualities or these two things, a well-rounded workforce and less risk, helps a company to reach the levels at the top levels in the corporate world. And women are giving their best in these two, which help company to move forward or to work better. Thank you.
I agree women are tech savers. So Shreya, I would ask you, what according to you are the biggest challenges a woman is facing and what is the hindrance for women in the today's scenario?
Anjali, we have all talked a lot about how the society has shattered up the idea of women directors. How women are not able to get to that position. But there are still women who have risen above all the failure, the struggle, all that hard work. They have been there. They are at the top position. One of my favorite of them being Kiran Majumdar Shaw, the chairperson and MD of Biocon. Kiran Majumdar Shaw, she went through a lot of struggle and doubt. From founding Biocon to being named India's richest self-made women entrepreneur, she has
risen above everything. She has been through a lot of struggle, and in fact, during her Economic Times interview during 2016, she said she accepted the fact that she is familiar with the criticism on social media. A lot of critical reviews on her decisions have been made. And she went on. She was like that, okay, these type of things happen in life. When you grow, when you achieve something, you will face criticism. But if a woman wants to succeed in the field, she has to shake off that kind of critical opinion and go with it.
I will ask you again. Transformation is taking place. We all know transformation is taking place. Women are being added to the board. Because of the report, again I am mentioning a report stating Ajay Tyagi, the chairman of SEBI, he recommends company to have 20% of women in their board by 2020. And at least one woman is independent director. What do you think, Shreya, there is a need for this transformation?
Actually, over the past few years, we have been familiarized with multiple ethical setbacks. We all saw the Satyam scams, we all saw the Sahara scam, the Nirav Modi scam. Along with that, countries across the globe, they have been expanding their horizon. They have been adding multiple women, they have been initiating the whole process of adding more female directors to the board. With the European market and the needs, the European market has more than 23% women as directors. And the Asian market is competing neck to neck with them. We have 22% of women directors on board as of 2016. The Indian market in 2016 had 12.4% of women directors. 12.4% of women directors. So SEBI, along with multiple government bodies, they felt the need that, you know, just to fill that board, along with the world, and to tackle the ethical issues, we can increase the number of women directors. We discussed earlier that how having women on board leads to lesser ethical issues. There are examples, there are exceptions, but still. And in the recent headcount by Economic Times, 60% of national stock exchange companies have at least one independent female director. So I think change is happening somewhere in India.
Completely agree, there is a need to fill this loophole. As Shreya is saying, certain measures are taken up. Over the past few years, the companies are hiring women directors, I agree. But do you think, Nikita, is it enough to hire a single woman in this male-dominated board?
No, I think your single woman may be just seen as a symbol and thus may not be able to exert sufficient influence over the corporate decision. Hence, mass of female members is still required. Companies can promote female members on board by adopting various steps or measures. They can go for encouraging transparency. Transparency in a company with respect to equality between man and women. There are companies which do this. They provide a less tough work to women and tough work to men. But companies which are committed to increasing the promotion of women on board should actively promote equality within the organization, equality with respect to the work, recruitment, pay, hiring, mentorship, sponsorship, etc., etc. Companies should provide same level of responsibility, visibility, variety of positions to men and women, which stretch them and promote them towards higher level of high top posts. And transparency is an effective measure which can be taken by an organization in order to promote women, as at that time they feel of they'll be motivated actually. They'll be motivated in order to compete with men on the same foot. Taking an example of SEB, a multinational software company. SEB has committed to obtain the EDGE certification in order to accelerate the progress of women on the board. EDGE certification is that instrument which helps the company to implement impactful actions, impactful solutions, aiming at improving the representation of women at top levels by thorough assessment of practices, policies, and identifying the gap in the sponsorship. And because of this, now the company have a quota of 25% quota for female members in the third room. The company should provide enabling environment to women in the organization, as flexible work-life practices are key to retaining women leaders. A global market survey by Corporate Executive Board and Corporate Leadership Council say there's a link between the flexible working environment and intent to stay at a workplace. Also, the company should also take steps for sexual harassment, as stated by Riddhi earlier, that female often feel a difficulty of sexual harassment at their workplace, and because of this, they may not work properly or effectively or efficiently in the company. So, company should take various measures towards this, and there are other things too which also have to be seen. The working women which have the children, the crash facilities should be provided. Although there is law, but there are companies which do not provide. But then these are the things which have to be seen. These should not be like left over. Thank you.
Okay, coming to you, Drishti, what are your views on this? Do you really think there are measures to be taken?
If a presence of one woman can change the board dynamic, then the multiple women or the collaboration of women can do wonders. So, as if Silicon Valley companies have board with only one woman, along with Twitter, they include Groupon, LinkedIn, Pandora. More mature companies